All right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Christ Presbyterian Academy here in the Den for tonight's big district showdown between the visiting Hume-Fogg Blue Knights and your homestanding CPA Lions in a District 9 AAA girls soccer matchup. This is Phil Newman, your play-by-play broadcaster this evening. Also serve as Director of Communications here at the Academy. Pleased to bring you the broadcast tonight. We'll be joined a bit later by Alex Phillips, a CPA student, assisting with the broadcast. He's on the way this direction. In the meantime, it'll be yours truly with camera and play-by-play, so please, if you're just tuning in, bear with us. We're about 6 minutes away from scheduled start time of the game tonight. Both teams come into this big game undefeated and unscored upon in district play, District 9 AAA. So both teams doing very well this season. Hume-Fogg's record not quite as strong overall. They're at 5-5-1, but they've really come on strong in district play. Likewise, CPA, a bit better overall record. They've only dropped a contest and tied one. Dropped a couple and tied one. I don't have it in front of me. But thank you for joining us again. We'll look forward to a really strong game. Both teams bring significant strengths into this matchup. Lots of senior leadership. Although CPA is a little bit older team in terms of the starters, CPA starters at least five, maybe six seniors deep. And Hume-Fogg starters, looks like only two seniors, maybe three, starting for Hume-Fogg. So for what it's worth, a little bit deeper senior leadership on CPA's side. See Coach Brandon Gagliano over on the far side there. And I'm going to zoom in. I think I see RBA, our headmaster, Richard B. Anderson. There he is. Matter of fact, fist bumping some of the players. That may be Caroline Conley. Hard to tell from here. There's assistant coaches also next to him. To his left, Julie Curtis in the purple and Megan Blaylock in the gray. Coach Gagliano, I don't see at the moment. There she is, talking with her team. They come in. A couple things Coach Gagliano told me before the game down the field. Two things, really. Play the game they're capable of playing. Play their game. And then the second thing was composure. Not to lose their composure, but to keep calm and keep composed throughout the game. Now the officials will huddle in the middle of the field with both coaches and I think perhaps the captains. For Hume-Fogg, coached by Tracy McLean. Coach McLean, we'll see her. Where is she down there? In that mix somewhere. Saw her before the game, talked to her as well. I can't quite make her out this far away. Coach McLean brings her team in, doing really well. These teams met last year, district and region play. That was quite a game, 1-0 game for CPA. One goal, and they hung on to take the region title. Last year, memory serves, and went on, of course, all the way to the state championship game where they lost to CAK. But what a run for CPA. They started slowly last year, very slowly, and underwater, the record, and then they came back strong. Finished the season, very strong district region play, and went on to Chattanooga, won the quarters, won the semis, and a classic game, that overtime thriller game, with actually overtime and then PKs. Roma made the save to seal the victory, and then they went on to CAK. Very strong Christian Academy of Knoxville team came up just short, but what a great end to the season, and what a great way to start this year. This year they've started, as I mentioned, much stronger. Very few goals scored against CPA to this point. Meredith Roma, the senior, has been rock solid at goalkeeper. They've been stingy in the net. CPA's defense has been just tremendous. And we'll see them, Michaela Lee, a senior back there on defense, Mary Morgan Smith also. Several newcomers this year for CPA who will get the nod. Well, one player, a junior, who came on just at the end of the season last year in the quarterfinals to start, is Maddie Andres, number 5. You'll see her play up front. And we'll have, of course, a stalwart Lindsey Curtis in the mix, senior number 9. Mason Wampler, I mentioned Mason the senior, number 13. Olivia Ball, a freshman, will be one of the starters. Olivia, very strong off the middle school team from last year. Number 26, you'll see Olivia quite a bit. Another newcomer is Madison Hamilton, moved from Knoxville, and here for the first full school year. And Madison will get some play in the midfield for CPA number 27. And then we got Joy Myers, number 28, also a freshman. She will play quite a bit. They call her Jomo. That's her nickname, so you may hear me say Jomo for Myers. Starters for Hume-Fogg. And by the way, that was not all the starters for CPA. There were a few others that were going to be determined closer to game time, so I don't have every starter. I'll get it when they start playing. But for Hume-Fogg, it's going to be Hannah Lochel, number 2, defender. Lucy Crenshaw. Crenshaw will play keeper. She's a sophomore for Hume-Fogg. Abby Brown, number 7, will be a defender starting. She's a senior. Josie North, number 13, is a defender as well, a junior. Mackenzie Peebles. Time. Okay. We'll take a break. We'll be right back with you.
A pleasant good evening and welcome to the campus of Christ Presbyterian Academy, CPA. We're here tonight for the matchup between the visitors, Hume-Fogg Blue Knights, and the homestanding CPA Lions. Now, if you would please stand for the invitation to be given tonight by Phil Newman, Director of Communications at CPA, and then remain standing for the national anthem performed tonight by 2 CPA Lions, Susanna Cranford and Casey Smith. Please join me in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight for this beautiful day that you have created for us, this beautiful fall evening, for the chance to be outside and to enjoy it. We thank you for both of these teams gathered here, for Hume-Fogg. We welcome them to our campus and pray that they will feel welcome. And for CPA, we pray for young ladies competing on the field tonight that you will give them the strength to compete well and to compete with sportsmanship. And we thank you for the coaches and the officials and the parents. And we ask that you help all of us to keep in mind the bigger picture tonight. This is a game, and we appreciate the opportunity to play it. And may we be friends at the end. We thank you. We pray that you will keep the players safe. And let this be an evening that is given to your glory. And I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, this is Susanna Cranford and Casey Smith, 2 CPA students doing the national anthem. Beautiful voices, those young ladies. Cranford, sophomore, number 12, and Smith is a sophomore as well, number 20. It's a great job for them. We'll zoom out here and try to bring you the action as best we can, and with a essentially what is a one-man band right now as the officials come out toward midfield. Another newcomer for CPA is Mickey Dye, number 30, has been injured for about 10 days with turf toe, thinking that Dye is back in action tonight. Number 30, you'll see her out there. Coaches for CPA, I mentioned earlier, Coach Brandon Gagliano, head coach, assistant coaches Julie Curtis, Megan Blaylock, you saw those two, and then John Wilkinson, he's the guy out there in the black taking pictures right now. He coaches primarily goalkeeper. There he is, kneeling down, taking some video or photos of the team. Jay does a great job chronicling a lot of the highlights for the Lions there. In fact, there he is, getting a team shot of the starters. Maybe able to make out some of the ones I don't have. Didn't have exactly, wasn't clear on who was starting 100%. We'll get that. There's McCullough. So 22, McCullough's going to start. Looks like she starts a fair amount of games. Or is that Howe? That's Michaela Howe, I believe, the freshman starting. And if my numbers are correct. See Hume-Fogg lined up, ready to go on their side of the field. And I'm going to zoom out here and try to get the best run of play if we can. So bear with us on the play-by-play. 40 minutes to go here in the first half. It'll be 40-minute halves, and then district play like this, there won't be any overtime. In this game, it'll be a tie if it ends. No playoff game. There's a referee saying, keeper, are you ready? And keeper, are you ready? And we're going to have to zoom out a little bit more. I apologize. I'll just have to tell you what's happening. CPA gets the kickoff to start the game. First half action here. Lions trying to control the ball. Coach Gagliano said composure would be critical. That's Mary Morgan Smith with the ball, 23 in the back left. Stolen the midfielder by Hume-Fogg, driving down the middle. Now Michaela Lee trying to challenge. Played outside. A left-footed shot is blocked there on the back line by Myers. Jomo, number 28, playing right back. Michaela Lee, number 24, one of the center backs, along with Mary Morgan Smith. Here's the ball played across by Wampler over to Lindsey Curtis. Curtis, now Wampler tries to win it in the midfield. Here will be taken by CPA on the left. Played inside. Oh, nice move there by Maddie Andres. Couldn't quite control the ball, though. It was played way up by Hume-Fogg. Lee tracks it down. Michaela plays it outside to the right to Jomo. Up to the midfield. And who's that over there? Is that Conley? Can't quite see. 26 is Olivia Ball. So Ball starting at right mid. Inside mid, you've got Wampler, 13. Along with Howell, 22, it looks like. Up front, Maddie Andres, number 5. And on the left side, I mentioned Curtis, here, number 9. Played across, all the way across to the right side for Hume-Fogg. Challenging there nicely. Out of bounds, though, it'll be off of Hume-Fogg. That was a nice challenge by Mickey Dye, number 30. Dye is in the game. Looks like maybe playing perhaps a center midfield position. Played up there. Out of bounds, yep. Lindsay will throw it in. Curtis, that is. Inside toward Conley, who's back in. Conley had a little bit of an injury at practice yesterday and is doing better today. Apparently she had a little bit of a strain. Stolen away, though, by Hume-Fogg in the midfield, coming back the other direction. And Coach Mike Elson up here in the booth. Can see Coach Elson wearing many, many hats. Here it is. We have Alex Phillips on the way. Alex with an appointment. We'll be back. There's Lindsay Curtis challenged on the wing there by Orozco, 28, playing defender. It'll be a throw-in for CPA way down deep. Can't really see it right this second, but we'll see the ball. There you see the ball coming in, and it'll be Mickey Dye, 30, with the throw, looks like. Yes, it will. It'll be in, played in toward Maddie Andres. Andres back out to Dye. She centers it, but it goes to Hume-Fogg's Peebles, Mackenzie Peebles, 14, playing center midfield. There's Peebles with the ball right now. Peebles will be challenged, though, by Conley, rather. And Alex Phillips is here. How you doing there? Alex is here, CPA student. There's down the right side. Here's a cross coming across the middle. Andres heads it, beautifully done, but not quite strong enough to get in. That was a nice cross on the right side. Put in by, was that Howell? Couldn't quite tell. Michaela Howell on the cross. And Andres headed it, but not quite strong enough to get on goal. Well, it was on goal, but it was weak keeper grabbed it easily. That was Crenshaw, keeper for Hume-Fogg. Here's Conley, now playing it back. Up to Wampler in the midfield. Wampler looking for Andres up front. Andres has it, plays it back to Howell. No, yes, that's Howell. And then it's going to be all the way to the right side to... I'll get this straight eventually. That was Olivia Ball, 26. Now it's Curtis. Back to Dye. Now it's going to be Conley. Switching the ball across. Nice play right here for CPA. They're possessing the ball well. Now they have it stolen. I jinxed them right there. Headed up. Hume-Fogg now has it in the midfield momentarily at least. They play it up front to number 17, Pickerel. Pickerel has the ball. No, she passes it off. Cross coming. Left-footed cross beautifully put in there by number 21, Morris. Sarah Morris. It's still alive. Hume-Fogg, another cross. This time from the right side. Just past the on-running Morris. Nice cross. Back inside, Hume-Fogg, another chance. Another cross coming wide open. Dangerous, dangerous ball. Almost. It was teed up perfectly there for number 17, Pickerel. She couldn't quite get a foot on it. CPA fortunate there not to give up an early goal here, just 5 minutes into the game. So it's a goal kick for the Lions. That was dangerous. Three different crosses came across for Hume-Fogg. Goal kick coming up toward the midfield. There's Howell. She loses it, though. Hume-Fogg has the possession now momentarily. It's Michaela Lee, though, cutting her off. Good D there by Lee. The senior center back, solid player. Throw in coming. No score. 35 minutes to go, first half. Just played five. Wampler in the midfield over to Curtis. Curtis, can she get there? It's the blue little line there, not the football lines. The blue line is out. Curtis inside to Conley. Conley will behind her, behind the back to Curtis. Curtis will try to slow it, play it back to, that's Dye, in mid, in like left defender probably. She crosses all the way across the field to Olivia Ball. Olivia, won back by Hume-Fogg temporarily. There's Lee. Lee will win the ball and set up again here to Conley in center mid. There to Wampler. Wampler now across to Howell. Howell looking for Ball. That is Olivia Ball, right? 26, I think. Okay. Alex nodding yes. Alex knows a lot of these players. There's Curtis. Lindsay Curtis, a senior leader on the left side. Dangerous left-footed, or either way, right or left. She's got a dangerous shot when she gets cranks it. That time was a cross attempt. It was played out toward Roscoe. Roscoe has the ball now. She'll play up, but it's cut off by Wampler. And all the way up to where Mary Morgan Smith goes out of bounds. That'll be Hume-Fogg's throw-in. Early on, CPA has had a little bit more possession, but Hume-Fogg, the best scoring chances so far. They had those three crosses, and one of them was just out of the reach of Morris. It would have been an easy tap-in if she could have gotten there against Meredith Roman. Here's another chance for Hume-Fogg. Lee plays it out before Roman gets there. It's played out to Mickey Dye. She will send it up, but it's going to go to Hume-Fogg in the midfield. Good hustle there by Wampler to get back to it, though. Wampler now to Conley. Conley will play it up toward Andres, but Hume-Fogg wins it in the form of Peebles, 14. She plays, I think, a holding center mid. Peebles does for Hume-Fogg. Here's stolen away by the Blue Knights. Left-footed shot is off the mark, but dangerous, dangerous right there for Sarah Morris, 21. The senior had a great chance at it. Her shot just didn't quite find the mark. Shots on goal now. Maybe the one, CPA's one shot on the header by Andres, and a couple shots for Hume-Fogg. Here is Peebles penetrating down the center. Peebles with a shot off the mark, but CPA is getting outmatched, if you have to say, at least offensively on the chances right now. It's Hume-Fogg with more of those. Goal kick coming. Michaela Lee will take it. Up. That was Andreas way back trying to help win that ball. She'll now go back to forward and all the way to Mickey Dye. Dye up to Curtis. Curtis will get out of trouble momentarily and play it back to Mary Morgan Smith. Up to Caroline Conley. Conley toward Andreas. Can she win the ball? Nope. Stolen away there by Peebles. And back to Lochelt, number two, the center back. Lochelt is now challenging Olivia Ball over there. Ball will get a throw-in. Earn a throw-in off that. That was Lochelt, number two, challenging Olivia, the freshman. So a lot of playing time for a couple freshmen early. Howell's in the game, a freshman. Ball, another freshman. And Mickey Dye, I'm not sure what year she is.
Senior.
She's a senior.
Front page, transfer this year.
She's a newcomer, though, right?
Mm-hmm. Transfer from Page.
Ah, that's right, from Page in the offseason. That's right. Mickey playing left back right now. You got Mary Morgan Smith playing center back along with Michaela Lee on the right. You've got Olivia Ball, looks like. In the midfield, we have Caroline Connolly, too. Wampler, 13. Left mid is Lindsay Curtis. Right mid appears to be... I say that right mid. It wasn't Ball, actually. It's Ball's playing right mid. I got that mixed up. Defense is Jomo. Is Jomo Myers. And forward, Andres. Here's Howell back to Connolly. Connolly will try to shoot. Not quite enough on that one. It goes out of bounds for a goal kick. Good to have Alex here, recovering from a little bit of baseball injury last week. Went courageously up for a fly ball and did a little dance with the fence. And good to see Alex healing up nicely. Feeling better?
Yes, sir.
So Alex helping us out with the production. Did a great job with Coffeehouse Theater on that production. Here's a long ball played up, and Lee is able to cut it off. Out of bounds off of Mickey Dye, though. Throw in for Hume-Fogg. Header toward the center. Back to Curtis, though. Curtis will get it to Connolly, or toward Connolly. It's won, though, by Hume-Fogg. Nicely done there by Rethman, 24, who plays in the midfield. But here's CP on a counterattack. Andres to Wampler. Cut off by Rethman, though. Well done by her. Plays it up. Oh, nice 1-2 there, but CPA is able to disrupt it enough. It could have been a nice run for Hume-Fogg. It'll be played up out of bounds off of the Lions. So in the middle there, I mentioned 24 Rethman for Hume-Fogg, the Blue Knights, along with 14 Peebles. They're kind of two strong midfield players for Hume-Fogg. On the far right, we've got number 30 over here. That's Karis Graves. She plays a right mid. And up top is 27 Brooks, so Callie Brooks right there, playing up top center forward, or the forward, if you will, for Hume-Fogg. Here is CBA, though, on a chance. It's Maddie Andres sliding in. Still alive. Andres has the ball. She'll cross it. And out of bounds off of a Hume-Fogg player. Looked like Curtis was wide open there for a cross, and it was just not quite to her. So it was played out by Hume-Fogg. I believe it looked like it might have been Brooks. Here's a corner kick left. It'll be a left in-swinger from Lindsay Curtis. And she'll play it short to Wampler. What's the call? Referee says, hold on a minute. Let's do it again. Or is it a foul? Injured player. He's saying, yep. Bring somebody else in. So let's see who, what happened. Maybe, you know what? Maybe they've got some kind of, is it injury? Well, the ball played off of her out of bounds, right? And she may be feeling that. So out will go Hume-Fogg's number, I think 13. North, and in will come a number I can't read. Number 10, actually. It's Perling, Ashley Perling, a sophomore. So that was an injury replacement. And here's Curtis with the in-swinger coming. She'll get it toward the goal. Crosses it over. It's alive. Still alive. Wampler can't get over it. Can't get over it. Gets under it a little bit and goes out of bounds. There was a good chance for CBA. The ball goes over the fence to Mr. Dunn's property there. Look at that one back. There is a gate over there. So it'll be a goal kick for Hume-Fogg taken by Loschelt, number 2, their center back, senior, anchor in the back there, Hannah Loschelt. It's played not very well, actually, short. She kind of misfired, and fortunate for Hume-Fogg, it harmlessly off of Maddie Andres back to Crenshaw, the keeper. Crenshaw will punt it up to the right side and played toward the center. There's Dye. Back to Mary Morgan, and Wampler hustles to get it. Good job by Mason. We'll switch it across to Ball toward Andres, but not able to get to her. So now it's 27 minutes and a half to play. We've played about 12 and a half. Fans wanted a handball there for Hume-Fogg off of Wampler, but it's still alive. There's an overlap for Dye, and it'll be played out of bounds by Roscoe for Hume-Fogg. Nice run there by CPA. They have a throw-in. Quickly taken to Curtis. Curtis will cross it left-footed toward the goal. A little bit interesting ball there, but not too dangerous for Crenshaw, the keeper. And she makes the save easily. As we said earlier, if you're just joining us, both teams undefeated in district play and unscored upon. So it's definitely, this could be a defensive struggle. It could be decided on just one scoring chance. So every scoring chance will be hugely valuable tonight. There is the freshman Howell playing it up. Well, interesting ball there. Can we get there? And that looks like they're going to go right all the way into the box for Crenshaw, number 00, the sophomore goalkeeper. So a little bit younger keeper for Hume-Fogg. CPA's Roman is a senior. Let's see if that plays in the, at all. Experience level at goalkeeper may be a factor, although Crenshaw looks solid early. Roman a bit taller than Crenshaw at a glance. We'll see if that, if any of that makes a difference. I think back in came Hume-Fogg's player who, that was North. She's back in anyway. Under 26 minutes to go first half, no score. Phil Newman, Alex Phillips bringing you the broadcast. Now here's a chance for Hume-Fogg in the center. Switched across to the right. Closing fast is Dye. Good job by Mickey up to Curtis. Now to Wampler, and there's Maddie making a run to the left side. Andres, can she beat that one player? Yes, she may. Yes, she does. Andres on goal. Andres is heading toward the goal. She'll cut it back inside. Andres will lose it, though. He played out of bounds off of her for goal kicks. Nice play there by Loschelt, number two, to get back. Andres had a good chance there. Couldn't quite convert. Now it's Pickroll, number 17, playing up top, along with, I think, Brooks for Hume-Fogg. Low shell on the goal kick coming. It's played over the heads of the first wave and over Curtis's head, all the way to Mickey Dye, to Connolly. Connolly will have Hume-Fogg take it away momentarily. Here's a chance. Now that ball was played off of CPA. It'll come to Hume-Fogg. They'll play it all the way back to set it back up again. Cross, rather send up off the head of Michaela Lee. Now it's Hume-Fogg. Were they offside? No call. There's a collision down there in the corner. It'll be called against the Blue Knights. And I apologize if I can't get every number right. There's a glass. Mary Morgan Smith is down. The player who collided with her looks to be, I can't tell from this distance. There she is. It was Morris, 21, senior. And Mary Morgan appears to be okay. She's walking it off. Looks like rubbing some dirt on it. It'll be Michaela Lee with the free kick. It'll go out of bounds, though. 24 minutes, so 16 in here. CPA's girls, again, all the way to state final last year and trying to go back this year and make it one more victory. First things first, though, district play. This is a big game tonight. Oh, nice move there by Curtis. Curtis makes a beautiful move and we'll send it across beautifully. Andreas, can she get there? Well, or who else? Ball. She will play it out of bounds. It'll be off of Olivia, though. Out of bounds. So the freshman, good cross in there by Curtis. She had a gorgeous goal last year in the Fairview game here to the sub-state game. That was the only goal of the game, I believe. And she's deadly. If she gets a shot anywhere near 20 yards out or so, 24 yards out perhaps. So on this field, it would be approximately the 20-yard line on football, in football terms, would be a dangerous shot for Curtis anywhere from there on in. And there goes a Hume-Fogg fan. Same guy at the volleyball game. There come a bunch of those guys who were at the volleyball game with their no shirts on. Got to love the school spirit. CPA was victorious over Hume-Fogg in volleyball the other day. But a great, great match. Here is a free kick dangerously coming in. Here it'll be CPA's Lee taking it. Outswinger playing it is Olivia Ball. Almost gets a clean leg on it. Couldn't quite get the shot, but she got a part of it. And it went to Crenshaw, the keeper. She'll punt it. But it'll go to Dye. Played up to Curtis. It'll be out of bounds, though. Trying to get the ball there to Graves, number 30 on the right side. Couldn't quite do it, Crenshaw. So it's Orozco throwing it in now. Dye cuts it off. There's Howell, the freshman. She will head it, though, to Hume-Fogg. Peebles wins the ball back from Andres. Now over to Graves. Played up toward Pickrell. Fast player there. Number 21, Morris. Sarah Morris looks like a dangerous, fast athlete on this Hume-Fogg Blue Knights team. Played in quickly. Won by Peebles. She plays it through, but not going to get there. tackle there. Some of the fans wanting a foul. No call. Played up. Nobody there for CPA. That we got Andreas was playing quite a bit back. She dropped quite a bit back toward the defensive side and wasn't there. It'll be off of her out of bounds this time for a throw. And so the Lions will have the first sub of the game for them. Looks like, who is that over there on the far side with the orange shoes? Getting ready to come in. I can't see the number from this far. That's
she's a freshman.
Ah, okay. Last name, do we know the last name?
She's number 15.
Ah. Oh, Kara Wegner. Okay. Getting ready to come in. Good eyes there, Alex. He's got high school eyes. I'm looking through two panes of glass in my defense, though. Here's Wampler. We'll play it back to Dye. Dye to Wampler. Nice play there. But Curtis, that's beautiful little soccer. And the switch move is cut off, though, in the middle by Morris. Morris will play it up toward Pickerel. And Pickerel will fight for it with Lee. Michaela will get down to the corner and try to play it off of. Does a beautiful job of playing it off of Pickerel. That was textbook defense. Go to the sideline and make the ball play it out off of the attacker. Here comes the sub. It is Wegner. Thank you, Alex. And out will go Andre. So Wegner will be playing up top.
First game back since her concussion.
Concussion, that's right. She a freshman, number 15, and she will play attacker. There she is challenging for the ball right now. Okay. Thanks, Alex. There's been several injuries. Turf toe we mentioned for Mickey Dye. She's back. Connolly yesterday had a sore, what was it? She had a pulled muscle yesterday, didn't practice yesterday, so she's back looking fine in the midfield. We'll probably see Mallory McKellar some later as well. Here's a corner, though, for Hume-Fogg. It'd be an outswinger. Nicely done by Morris, but what a header, though, by Lee. Now CPA will try to get out of there. It is Wegner with the ball. She's fast. She still has the ball. She still has the ball. What a play there to relieve a lot of pressure, but it will go out off of Kara Wegner. She's quick. A lot of speed there. Here's Conley playing it up toward Wegner again. CPA going with one forward right now. Looks like maybe a 4-5-1. I can't quite tell. That'll be for Curtis. Can she get there? Yes, she does. Out of bounds, though, off the shin of Curtis. Nice play there by Graves, number 30, for Hume-Fogg. No score. Just under 19 minutes remaining first half, so we're more than halfway through the first half. That's what we expected, a defensive struggle. Both teams play extremely well, extremely good defense, and don't give up many goals, so something's got to give tonight. Or it could be a 0-0 tie, I suppose. So they hope for some goals, or at least one. At least one for the team in white, Alex says, yes, for CPA. Here's Orozco playing it all the way across, picked off by Ball, up toward Wegner. Gotta love those orange shoes, can't miss her feet. See Hume-Fogg across the back, playing it up. That's Pickerel looking for Graves. Graves has the ball. She'll try to send it, but it's cut off there by Connolly nicely to Curtis. We had a lot of fun last year with all the different names, all the C and K names on the CPA team. It's impossible to get them all straight in M's, either M or K. And we'll go through a list later because you can just—it's amazing how many M's and how many K sounds there are.
You got three Michaelas.
Played up. We got a lot of Michaelas. We got Mallory McCullough. We got Mary Morgan. We've got Caroline Connolly. We've got Courtney Cohn. On and on. It's just fun. There's a foul called. The fans for Hume-Fogg not happy about that. Referee looks like he's not fazed at all by the fans. He's got to be calm and cool. Once again, if you're just joining us, Coach Gagliano before the game said two keys for CPA, just play the game they're capable of playing. They know how to play. And then two, keep their composure. Don't get rattled, especially as the game goes on. If there's not a score yet, don't get frustrated, but just keep composed. That's a good rule for much of life, not only soccer. Here's Dye playing it in the middle of Conley. Conley, well, up toward Howell. Howell will switch it across all the way to Olivia Ball. Ball up to Wegner. She will take it on the right side. Yes, she will try. Cut off by Loschelt. Nice play by the center back there, number two for Hume-Fogg. There's Conley, taken away momentarily. One back, though. Conley to Wampler. Has a little bit of space. That's closing tightly, though, but Wampler would go looking to thread it through the needle there to Olivia Ball. Not quite able to. Headed up by Jomo. There's some cowbells going on somewhere. That wind chimes or... That's cowbells down there by the Hume-Fogg guys. Here is Conley. Wampler. Ball. Or Dye, rather. Dye will take a shot. Dangerous! It's in! What a play! Mickey Dye with the shot off the hands of Crenshaw, the keeper, and into the net. What a beautiful kind of a knuckleball shot there from probably somewhere in the neighborhood of 35 yards out from goal. What a nice crack there by Dye. And I said it earlier, we wondered about the goalkeeping. A little bit of height advantage for CPA there. Crenshaw, don't have her height listed, but I think she's not as tall as, say, Meredith Roman for CPA. That may have been a factor. The ball just hit her in the hands and went over into the net. So CPA will take the lead. 1-0. There's Curtis. Get the scoreboard updated there. Now Curtis out down the left side. Yep. Played it in, but off of the foot of 13, Josie North, junior defender for Hume-Fogg. So good play there. Going back to that shot by Mickey Dye. Didn't need a lot of room. She cranked it. Too much power for Crenshaw to stop that time for the Blue Knights. Looked like about the 20, which would make it about 30-ish yards out, 30 to 35 yards on the soccer field. Yeah, about 30 yards out. The goal is basically at 10 yards into the end zone, if you will. Header played out by Hume-Fogg nicely. Good howl and good corner, though, that time. Now that may be a foul against CPA, not called. Here is one by Sarah Morris, the speedster, number 21. Morris taken away there by Lee. Nice job by Kayla Lee. She's solid back there on defense. Played in, though. Hume-Fogg has it. It's Peebles through traffic. Challenged by Lee. Peebles still has it for a moment. Now it's back to Howell. Howell will step through it and get it out to Olivia Ball. Ball, what a move. Can she get it up forward? Can Wagner get there? No, it'll go out of bounds. But that means the pressure was relieved, so good job there by Ball. And a good job by Michaela Lee, the center back, one of the two center backs for the Lions. It's a little play of 4-5-1, I think, meaning four backs. Of course, the keeper as well. Five through the midfield and that 1-4, which is Wagner right now, the freshman, as Andres went out for a breather or for a break or for rotation. Here is Dye, the goal scorer. To Curtis, Mary Morgan up to Conley. Conley will get it switched across to Ball. Ball cuts inside. Ball cut off by Peebles. Nice job by the Blue Knights right there. And then a challenge on the outside. One, not quite able to keep it in there, was Olivia Ball as she challenged Abby Brown, number 7, the senior defender on the left side for Hume-Fogg. So 1-0 Lions lead. We got about 13.5 remaining until halftime. We may do a little talk at halftime about homecoming and what the kind of the fun the week has been. I know Alex has been part of that mix with getting some videos produced and different things for tomorrow, especially. We'll talk more about that. Lions trying to build on that lead. That may be a handball, not called, inadvertent, off Hume-Fogg, out of bounds. That'll be CPA throw-in. Another sub coming in. Is that Courtney Cohn? Yes, looks like Courtney Cohn coming in. Out will go Curtis. So Cohn for Curtis. There you go. Number 3, Courtney Cohn is a sophomore, I believe. No, she's a junior, my bad. There's Wampler over to Cohn. A lot of space right now, closing as a Roscoe. Can Cohn get past her? She can't, and that may be a foul call. Yes, it is, against Cohn, yes. Got some leg or some foot there on the right back, a Roscoe. Don't think she meant to do any harm there, just caught the foot. talking to Meredith Roman yesterday in the hall. Keeper hadn't seen much action yet tonight, but Roman was saying same thing Coach Gagliano said. They just play their game. They're capable of playing. They're confident they can beat anybody if they play up to their abilities. Here's the there's a lot of legs flying. They're going to call that dangerous play, I think, on Brooks. Brooks was on the ground playing the ball. That's usually not allowed. Here's Conley. A little pinball action right now in the center. Conley will turn it out to Cohn. Cohn will cross it toward Wegner, but it will be won back by Hume-Fogg, at least for the moment. But there's Dye playing it to Wegner. Wegner drops it back to Courtney. Wegner, little 1-2-3 right there. Dye will switch it nicely. Good idea there to switch. Clear out that left side. It was kind of crowded over here. There's Olivia Ball playing it. It's still in. Up toward Howell in the midfield. But now it's Hume-Fogg's Peebles coming out of there with it. She's a skillful player as well. Peebles plays it back. Now it's headed up by Morris. 11 minutes to go, first half. So we play 40-minute halves. We are 30, not quite 30 in.
Maddie Andres for Conley.
Andres back in. And, yep, thank you, Alex Courtney, or rather, Caroline Conley goes out. Andres back in, and she'll play, looks like a kind of a center mid spot. So they'll keep Wegner up at forward and bring Andres as a midfielder. Maybe an attacking midfielder, I would guess, because Andres definitely can attack. Strong forward, offensive presence. Played in toward Howell. Now it's Wampler. Wampler up toward Wegner. Wegner back to the goal. Now she puts it across beautifully to Ball outside. Ball will cross it. Who's there? Is Cohn there? Somebody there. Wampler was there for a moment. Played out by Hume-Fogg, though. Nice job. Here's Howell fighting Peebles for it. Peebles plays it up, but it's going to be won by Jomo. Now Olivia Ball. Another cross coming, but nobody there, really. That'll go to Crenshaw. CPA up by one. Big shot by Mickey Dye, newcomer this year. There's the ball going over the head of Wampler. Played up. Jomo wins it momentarily, but Peebles has it now. She plays it up to Morris, Sarah Morris, trying to get a kind of an angle pass up ahead to, it looks like Maddie Crenshaw, number 6, I believe, in the game for the Blue Knights. Here's Graves. Challenged by Cohn. Andres has it now. Andres will do a little heel pass to herself. Play it up in the direction of Cohn. Cohn trying to shield off Rethman there. Can't quite do it. Out of bounds for Hume-Fogg. Another sub coming in. This time it's Curtis back in. And Olivia Ball, I think, goes out. They'll shift around a little bit. Let's see what they do. Courtney Cohn will go either out or switch sides. I can't tell. She'll switch over to the right. Curtis back to the left. Curtis, left-footed specialist. So Wegner still up top. Cohn playing maybe another forward or right mid. Hard to tell. Lee, did good job by Michaela playing that one out. Throw in for Hume-Fogg. Cross coming. Howell there. Ball will skirt out of bounds off of the Lions. 8:15 remaining first half. This big district matchup. Both teams undefeated in District 9AAA. And no one scored on them yet in district play. Here's Andres. She'll win the ball. Andres, a chance for CPA here. She'll play it up toward Wegner. Wegner will play it, I guess, up the right side. Maybe not. She'll hold it up and wait for the cavalry. Wegner, nice play there by Hume-Fogg's Brown, Abby Brown. CPA throw in. The Brown stopped the tide momentarily. There's Cohn. Is it off of Hume-Fogg? No. Goal kick for the Blue Knights. It was off of Cohn. CPA trying to win this game and take the driver's seat in district play into the playoffs. District, of course, region, sub-state, state. They are certainly a deeper team even than last year's team, and capable of going a long way if they play their brand of soccer. Here's Hume-Fogg controlling Orozco. Will send it way up toward the right side. Mary Morgan there for the header. Controlled down by Wampler. Now she'll play it back to the center to Lee. Lee tries to switch it there and gets it, yep, all the way to Cone. Playing it back now to Jomo. And up. That was a nice little switch fields and possession play. Then CBA lost it. Here's Peebles. She'll switch it across. Try to, but it's going to be cut off. What a nice play there by Smith. Mary Morgan, or now that, I'm sorry, it's Dye. Mickey Dye, not Smith. And then she goes down with a hip. She goes down holding her hip. A little bit of a collision there. We'll see if they play it out of bounds here. They may or may not. Yeah, they. I think Hume-Fogg may play it out of bounds. That worked out well. They didn't mean to, but usually you want to play it out of bounds when someone's hurt and then get the ball back after the player recovers. Dye is trying to stretch down there right below us on the sideline. She looked like she kind of nipped her hip nipped a Hume-Fogg player, and there she's trying to stretch. So she's staying in. Really should have been given to Hume-Fogg, and now, well, it's throw in for them, worked out for them. Usually what you do in that situation, whoever plays it out will get the ball back to start play after the injury timeout. Here's Crenshaw. Referee doesn't call that. He's shaking his head. No. Hume-Fogg fans wanted a call. Now he calls something. Now he calls Dye, perhaps. The second one, now the fans are giving a little Bronx cheer, I think, to Mr. Referee. They thought the first one was a foul, but it wasn't called. Referee talking now to Sarah Morris, 21. Morris, it appears, is Hume-Fogg's, I would say, strongest player in terms of speed and quickness, which is so important. There's Lee playing it. There will be what? What's happening? Clock is stopped. It'll be a yellow card given to, I can't tell whom, but I think it's a Hume-Fogg player, right?
Hume-Fogg player. 21.
For the challenge there.
No, 29.
She must go off. So 29 looks like Pitts, freshman. She was given a yellow for the challenge, I think, and went off. Maybe the referee judging that she came in a little too hot or too cleats up or who knows what. But anyway, it was a warning. They call it a caution in soccer. So one more of those, and she's out of the game and out of the next game. So two yellows equal a red. Or a straight red if you do something really, really egregious. Here's Dye. Apparently the hip is okay. She'll play it across to Jomo Myers and cut off by Morris. Morris, but then Myers wins it back. CPA appears to be going with two forwards right now. If I can see straight, maybe not. Maybe two attacking midfielders. Played up. There's Mary Morgan Smith, though, in the center. Lee is there. Crenshaw to Morris. And Jomo comes through. A little bit of, again, pinball in the center right now. 4 minutes to go. First half, CPA up by goal. Played through. Out of bounds off of the Lions. Good hustle there by Rethman, 24. Junior forward, or junior midfielder, tonight for CPA. Here, though, is Myers. I believe she's the cousin of all the Myers. The soccer Myers. A nice save there by Roman coming out to get it off of Crenshaw's foot. Maddie Crenshaw, number 6, was close, but senior goalkeeper Roman was out fast enough. First really tough save of the game for Roman. First save maybe at all. Couple shots on goal, but nothing has been too hurt so far till that one. 3.5 minutes to go, first half. Had a big eating contest today at the pep rally. None of the girls out here took part in that, though. That was probably frowned
Mickey
upon.
Did.
Did Mickey
Mason
eat some? Oh, Mickey actually ate the baby food.
Yes, she did.
Mason did too. Oh, Mason. Okay, all right. I stand corrected.
And Kendall Miller.
Wow, I think I thought none of them were going to be allowed to do that.
Lots of Lady Lions.
So Dye, Miller, and Wampler. Here's another shot by Dye, cut off. The baby food may have given her extra strength. We did see Wampler with the baby food, and Dye, what did Kendall do?
Kendall did saltine crackers.
Ah, okay, saltine crackers.
We got a sound
lady. Maybe a JV player. There was a JV game before this.
Okay.
Can't tell. Hopefully not a major thing. 2:39 and running here, first half. The referee will keep a time after 2 minutes. What's happening here? Referee has the official time on the field, or after 2 minutes, so usually they'll stop it and let him So it's going to be a free kick for CPA. They lead by a goal. It will be the baby food eater, Wampler, taking this free kick. And it's a nicely played ball in toward Andre. She gets a header to Curtis. Curtis will shoot over the goal. 3 points for Lindsay Curtis, but no goal. That would be not her strongest leg. She's a left footer by nature, by design, I should say. Right foot is not quite her forte, but she's good with both. In that case, went over the goal. Good chance there for the Lions. Now will be about 2 minutes to go. Goal kick played out. One back by the Lions. There's Andres. Shot goes over. Who was that in the middle? Wegner, I think, and Andres were combining there. They give a little five to each other to say, hey, good try. Goal kick coming. CPA has to be happy if they go in to halftime. A goal up, obviously. Goal kick taken toward the right side. Orozco will try to win it. She does. Plays it up, though, out of bounds. Looking for Kirsten Rice, a junior. Wasn't quite able to corral that one. So there have been several subs for Hume-Fogg. I may have missed a couple of those. So we'll try to get players' names. Oh, nice play by Wegner, but it's going to be won by Hume-Fogg on defense. And that was off the leg of Rice. Well, they're going to say yes. CPA throw. Halftime, any time now, the referee will blow the whistle for half. There's Wegner. Ball played to the right side, left side rather, by Orozco, number 30. Number 30? 28, rather. Throw in will be taken by Curtis. There's Wegner with the ball now, back to the goal, to Curtis. Curtis with left-footed cross coming, dangerous, but played out momentarily to Wampler. Wampler makes a move. Stolen away, though, by Morris. Morris trying to play it up. She will. Nicely done there, but Lee will track it down and play it back to Roman, who will clear, well, try to clear, will whiff the clear, and it goes, but thank goodness it goes to Mary Morgan Smith. So it didn't go right to a Hume-Fogg player. There's Morris with a shot just off target. I told you, Sarah Morris is dangerous. Morris, number 21 there, is a senior. She's speedy and skillful. I know CPA will have an eye on her extra cautiously in the second half. I would think the whistle will blow just about any second for halftime. We're live from the den here at CPA. District matchup, 9AAA. CPA leads 1-0 over Hume-Fogg. Referee will check his watch, I would expect. The watch did stop a couple times during that half, or once for the yellow card and once for an injury, I think. There's Wegner trying to play it. Wegner heads it up. Out of bounds. Nicely there, done by Josie North. Lions had the throw. Curtis to Conley. But it's won by Peebles. Peebles up toward Crenshaw. Maddie Crenshaw. Mary Morgan tries. Here's Peebles coming through, challenging Conley. Conley will get it outside of the right to Jomo. Jomo over to Conley, or to Cone. I told you there's too many C's and K's. Throw in for Hume-Fogg. It's hilarious, actually. We'll go through the whole list later. Throw in for the Lion. Nope. Throw in for Hume-Fogg. Taking up to Crenshaw through her legs. There's Lee. Yep. Actually, it's Hume-Fogg controls the ball right now. Rice plays it up toward. There's Rethman with the ball. 24. She'll look for help. Coming back to help is Wegner there. Nice job by Wegner to hustle back from forward. Now here's Curtis controlling it with Orozco on her. Can she get around her? She will. What a nice left-footed cross all the way over to Cone. But the whistle blows for halftime. So we'll have halftime. There's Lindsay down there stretching something as she goes off. Maybe just a little bit of a gimp or a little bit of a, I don't know, a little bit of a muscle spasm there. Who knows? So at halftime, we'll tell you, Lions lead 1-0 off a great shot by Mickey Dye, senior, right, number 30, with a gorgeous goal that went off the hands of keeper Lucy Crenshaw and into the net. So Lions go up by a goal in this key matchup. Said it before, we'll say it once more. Both teams are undefeated in district play and unscored upon it. Well, they were. Hume-Fogg was till tonight. So we have about 10 minutes to go till the second half. Maybe we'll do a little conversation here with Alex Phillips. Tell us about homecoming week. What have been some of the highlights for you this week and for your classmates?
Definitely the dress-up days were pretty awesome. Watching people get really creative, you know, especially one of my senior friends, Lucas Spicker, today, dressing up as a mini Uncle Sam and for USA Day. And, you know, definitely the eating contest was pretty awesome to watch. People throwing up and eating lots of Crystal Burgers and, you know, baby food. It was pretty fun to watch.
That was Lucas Spicker. I didn't know who that was in the in the outfit. That's
just
a picture of him. I think will be on our Facebook page, CPA's Facebook page. So I guess on, let's see, one day was Blast from the Past Day.
What You Want to Be When You Grow Up was another one. And then, today we dressed up in, according to the U.S. flag. We were trying to get the crowd to get into a U.S. flag. It didn't quite work out, but, like, I would dress up in all red, and maybe another house would do all blue, and then one do all white, you know.
And, of course, you mentioned the houses. That's a new concept for those maybe grandparents or folks tuning in. New thing this year at CPA, we have four houses in the high school based on Scottish clans. Which house are you in, Alex?
I'm in the Wallace clan.
Ah, that's ours too.
Yes, sir.
So, and we're in last place, aren't we?
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. We're all pretty, it's a tight race, though.
But
you know, it's like my physics teacher, Mr. Barlow, said, it's like how we do freshman, sophomore, junior, seniors. And over in Britain, it's like the houses and the freshman, sophomore, junior, senior thing's like a crazy concept to them. So it's interesting, you know.
Mr. Barlow, of course, was instrumental in helping develop the concept over the summer. Well, first of all, it was the student government, student leadership with Mr. Morrow, but then I think Mr. Barlow was kind of consulted because he's an expert on on the house concept. So we have four houses. There's Sutherland, Barkley,
McKinnon,
and Wallace, and they're competing for the coveted Anderson Cup, which is a brand-new award named for our headmaster, Richard Anderson, who was over there, still is over there, right next to CPA's team. You see him in the purple jacket and the ball cap. Mr. Anderson, of course, the only headmaster in the almost 28-year history of CPA, so certainly a fitting thing to name the cup after him. And tell us a little bit about some of the broadcasting stuff you're doing this week that may be shown tomorrow. Actually, we may be able to show one of them at the halftime of the football game.
Oh, yeah. Right now we're doing a Right Now video, which is tradition every year for, I think, at least the past several years. They've done a Right Now video to the Van Halen song Right Now, and you know, they've done football highlights and inside jokes that only CPA students and staff would know, you know. And we've got a soccer promo video coming up, and of course our weekly WCPA news.
Cool. Yeah, we're gonna try to show something either pregame or halftime of tomorrow night's football game. We may show the news clip or Right Now video or soccer promo, something, whatever we can.
Yeah.
So if you're out there watching and you can't be with us tomorrow night in the den for homecoming, you can watch it online and see all that fun. So what about baseball? Alex, you guys are obviously in the off season. Are you doing any kind of off season workouts?
You know, we are, and of course, cross country's in season. You know, we do lots of things. Like, we go out, and actually when we're working out and stuff, we're on the soccer, or close to the soccer field on the track, and we can see the girls' soccer team practicing, and we have the basketball teams in off season, so we, you know, run with them sometimes, and it's nice.
Yeah, cross country.
Nice throwing.
Yeah, a little throwing, and yeah, I know the rule is a rule about that. The coaches can't coach hitting, right? They can coach technique for throwing. No fly balls.
Yeah.
That's an off season rule. So we have cross country, we have football, we have Hume-Fogg. Some of their fans. These guys are great. You can see them now down there with a couple of their guys. They came in the volleyball gym. By the way, congrats to our volleyball team led by Coach Martha Sheffield with a big victory on Tuesday against, and they also won today against Stratford. See if we can grab Coach Mike Elson. Coach Elson, do you have a second here? Athletic Director Mike Elson joining us. He's up here handling the whole event, I guess. Coach Elson, we were just talking with Alex here about the fall sports and everything that's going on at CPA. There's quite a bit happening. It's homecoming week. We've got cross country going. We've got girls soccer. We've got football. We've got a lot going on. How would you summarize the start of the school year and any highlights for our fans out there watching tonight?
Well, I'll start with girls soccer, which we're watching here tonight. One of my favorite games so far was CPA at Innsworth. And Innsworth went up early, first 6 minutes of the game, you know, led 1-0. And we kept battling, and Michaela Howell lofted in like a 40-yard goal with 15 minutes to go. And it was just a dogfight the rest of the night. So those are the kind of games, as an athletic director, I love watching us compete in. We had another neat thing today. Our girls' varsity volleyball team, led by Martha Sheffield, went over and competed during the school day at Stratford High School at 1 p.m., and they allowed students that were in a good academic standing to come to the game. So it was neat just traveling with the girls. We took them over on the bus and brought them back. And so, needless to say, it's been a busy day when you think about a high school athletic event going on during the school day and then our game tonight. And I know the seniors are going to decorate after the game up at the high school building, and then tomorrow all the activities, pep rally. And we're not only gearing up for seeing our alumni tomorrow night, but getting ready for our Fox 17 game of the week next Thursday. That'll be fun as well.
Huge. Lots going on at the academy. And, of course, when it comes to soccer, we were talking earlier about the girls' amazing run last year all the way to the state championship game down in Chattanooga against CAK. And this year's team, on paper, appears to even be a little bit deeper. And you never know what's going to happen from year to year. But what a run they made last year.
Well, we had two to three seniors leading us. Abby Kenya and Ellie Ambrose come to mind immediately, just stepping up. And I think at one point that team was 3-10. And rose up when it counted, and just really toughened up and believed they were going to win. And to lose in the state championship game was impressive. This is Brandi Gagliano's sixth year at CPA, and every year she's taken the CPA Lions to the state tournament. So I will be anxious to see how this team meshes both with the experience that we have, along with a lot of youth. We have a lot of freshmen making an impact. And also to the point, we have so many players interested. We had a JV game this afternoon, and watching the girls play in a JV season, knowing long-term benefits for the program, for them, is making soccer at CPA a lot of fun. One thing I failed to mention is that our golf teams will be competing for a region championship on Monday at Montgomery Bell State Park. And then we had a first or special thing happened. Our girls finished runner-up as a team, and Sierra Stout, an eighth grader, actually finished as the district runner-up.
Wow.
For grades 8 through 12, that's pretty special. And we're excited to see not only what her and Mary Monroe are going to be able to do next Monday, but to watch Sierra's high school career unfold. So that was real special. Our boys finished third, and they've got some battling to do on Monday. One team advances, per girl and boys region. Teams
out of the
region into the state tournament. And we've had the fortune of being there a few times, so hopefully our guys will play well and our girls, and we'll see what happens from there.
Yeah, can't forget golf. Coach Steve Wilson, and I'm not sure who else is helping, but all right, thanks Coach Mike Ellison joining us at halftime. We're about ready to start, about a minute and a half till the second half, but appreciate Coach Ellison, and lots going on at CPA athletically. And obviously academically and fine arts-wise. See, right now I saw the middle schoolers over there rehearsing for Willy Wonka Jr., which I think is next weekend, October 5th. And I believe it's next weekend. But if you're a CPA family, CPA parent or grandparent in town, look at the website. You'll see information about that. Of course, we have homecoming tomorrow night. East Nashville comes to CPA, to the Den. Then there's the dance on Saturday night. So lots going on. You going to the dance?
Yes,
Alex is going to the dance, all right?
Yes,
sounds good. Should be fun. Want to give a shout-out to your date at all? Or
actually,
who's the lucky girl? Right, she's in the game. Who's that?
Michaela Lee.
Oh, Michaela Lee. Okay, so, I got to say, that's on paper, that's a good matchup height-wise. I mean, because she's tall and you're not short. I'm going to get in deep trouble if I don't be quiet. I mean, you guys are...
You're all good.
I'm sure you're going to have a great time. My son gets to go, too, for the first time. Freshman.
Yeah.
So, it'll be fun.
Club 2323 is the theme.
Is that right?
Like
Club 2323. Oh, 50s. Okay. So we'll see. That'll be fun. But right now we have another half of soccer to play, and we'll see if the Lions can either keep or build on their lead. 1-0 here at the half. Change our scoreboard here to second half action. I mentioned Coffee House Theater earlier. You can watch that beautiful production online on the same place you are now. Just go look at the events, and you'll see the Coffee House Theater. Alex was a big part of that production. That was a lot of fun. A lot of amazing talent, really, here at the Academy, and just came together. What about Lydia Graner, that song she wrote,
song.
The hipster song, and then also 20 years from now, what was the name of that? I can't remember. Who sang it, but another student wrote her own song and sang it. It's beautiful. I apologize for not getting the name, but either way, look, check it out on the same TWSW network. It says it looks like a sports site that we're on, but we have other events as well, not only fine arts events coming up, but also some academic events. We'll have graduation again. We'll do a couple other things as the year goes on, maybe 40s Day, which was fun last year. So stay tuned for lots more fun if you can't be here. Second half starting momentarily. There is Alex waving to Michaela, and there you go. We'll see if the camera stays on her the whole half. We'll know something's up, if something's fishy there, if that happens. Here's Curtis going for it. Orozco meets her, but Curtis gets around her. There's a nice cross by Curtis, and a shot just over the goal there by Wampler. What a beautiful cross by Lindsay Curtis. Wampler was there. Andreas was there as well. Good chance early on for CPA. They came out of the gate firing. Goal kick will be taken here by Lochell, I think that was. Yep. Out of bounds off of Conley. She's shaking her head down there. She kind of mishit that one. CPA looks energetic to start the second half. Olivia Ball fighting for it there. Andres also played back to Howell. Ball, but CPA, or rather Hume-Fogg, wins it back, at least for the moment. There is Jomo Myers right below. Everything switches sides, of course, at halftime. So the Lions going now toward the west to our right. Here's Conley. Taken away, though. There's Peebles with it. Peebles makes a move. Try to play it up toward Morris, but it'll be taken by Howell. Howell's the sister, I think, Parker Howell, if I'm thinking straight. So athletic family, the Howells.
Basketball
player. Parker, outstanding basketball player. Keeps on growing. He's eating his Wheaties. Getting taller. So Michaela. Is it three Michaelas we have now? Lee, Howell, and Dye. They call her Mickey, I think, though, for short. And two Madisons. There's a shot on goal. Just into the keeper's arms, taken by Andres, I think it was. Yes, it was. A good save there by Crenshaw, the keeper. Here is Hume-Fogg with it, challenging as Jomo. Now Dye back to Mary Morgan. Will they play it? Yep, all the way back to Roman. Smart play there. Just kind of relieve the pressure and then maybe let Roman can see the whole field. And she plays up. No, nice play there by Conley. Just a nice touch out to Ball. Ball looking for Andres. We'll play it up toward her. Can Andres get around Lochelt? She wins the ball. Plays it back to Wampler. Wampler. Now back to Andres. Good job there. The cross coming, yes, or the shot on goal, but won by Lucy Crenshaw. Fans here in the den. Good amount of fans in the bottom section of the stands right here for both teams. Played out off of Dye over there. She with the pink hairband tonight. That's Mary Morgan Smith. Orozco has it stolen away by Andres. Play back to Andres from Curtis, but out of bounds. Mary Morgan challenging. Mary Morgan will control and get it up toward the front. Here is Michaela Lee. Fans didn't like that one. Yeah, Michaela got flagged for a little bit of a tackle right there, a little bit of a foul. Not a whole lot going on there, but enough apparently for the referee to call it. So Hume-Fogg will set it up right around midfield. And that will be north, shooting toward the east. Crossing, rather, sending it in toward Dye over her head. Dangerous for a moment. It'll be off the foot of Hume-Fogg if they call it. Yeah, they do. I think Dye helped the referee there, the linesman, but that was the right call. Just in the second half, 36. Need a little bit of help. Couldn't see it. Dye was helpful enough to say, hey, it's our ball. And if she was right. There is Howell. Lions, of course, in white. Hume-Fogg in blue. Visiting Blue Knights, that's their nickname. It was a really spirited volleyball game the other day between these two schools, and CPA pulled away to win 3-1. It was a really hard-fought matchup. Coach Elson mentioned that one. Here's Hume-Fogg's Morris. Morris, dangerous. Morris will try to send it in left-footed, but there's Lee. Out of bounds off of CPA. Hume-Fogg fans down there cheering for their teammate. That was Abby Brown. I'm not sure what they were saying there. Couldn't hear it. Here's up toward Lee. Will win the ball back, though. Nicely done there from Brooks. Brooks, 27, was challenging for it. Off the Lions, though. Brooks or Morris down there throwing it in. It's Morris, 21. She's tough. Played out of bounds by Jomo. Very, very few goals given up by Roman. I don't have the numbers in front of me, but just maybe two goals, maybe two for the whole season given up so far by the Lions. They're stingy on defense. I don't want to jinx them, though, but there's Connolly playing it up to Andres. Andres with a header straight up in the air. Andres still wearing her makeup from the Patriot Day today. Blue face paint. Makeup. Here's Morris with a cross off of the CPA. It's in the goal. Oh, my goodness. Well, my goodness. Morris, what did we say earlier? Dangerous player for Hume-Fogg. And she took a left-footed shot that I believe went off of Lee and into the net. So just an unfortunate carom there for CPA. And Morris gets the goal. 34 minutes to go, second half. So about 46 minutes into the game. Morris, we said it. She definitely is one to be reckoned with. And that time it showed. So the game is knotted all of a sudden here, second half. Despite the fact that CPA has had more chances, that time there's Morris sliding in. That time Hume-Fogg capitalized and really was just something you can't control that one. It went off, I think it went off Lee's leg or foot and under Roman. Just couldn't stop it. That happens sometimes. Soccer bounces are crazy. But give Morris credit for a hard shot. Here's Mary Morgan playing it up. So now that will be the first goal given up in district play by CPA. And it's one piece. So the Lions, can they keep their composure, as Coach Gagliano said before the game, just play their game and see if the results come? There's Dye to Conley. Up to Andres, drops it over to Curtis. Inside, Curtis goes, looking all the way across, back to ball. Good play by CPA right here. Can she control it, though? Morris speeds in there to take it away. She'll play it up the left side. Out of bounds, off, they're going to say, off of Hume-Fogg. Well, we said several times in this game how dangerous Morris is. That time it paid off for Hume-Fogg on the goal. Conley to Howell. Wampler trying to win the ball, but she's challenged nicely by Hume-Fogg. And up toward Pickerel it goes, but won back by Lee. Mary Morgan out of Connolly in the midfield. She'll play it all the way toward ball. On the right side, it'll be a little bit too far for her to track down. Hume-Fogg right now at forward has Pickerel, number 17. 27 also, Brooks, Callie Brooks. Is either playing forward or attacking left mid. There's ball. Tackle off of it by Peebles. Morris is around the ball, too. Peebles and Morris in the midfield finding their way around the ball. That time went out of bounds, though, off of Hume-Fogg. There's Jomo into Olivia. Conley will switch fields, perhaps try to, and no. Well, yes, but cut off, though, by Pickerel. Pickerel saw that one coming and adjusted back from forward to midfield. Here fighting for it is Curtis along with Graves, number 30. It's Howell, though, has the ball now. Over to Olivia Ball. Ball looking for Andres on the run. Andres, can she get there? She's speedy. Lochelt beats her to it, plays out of bounds, but CPA will have the ball deep down on the Hume-Fogg defensive side. In their defensive third, as it were in soccer, you have thirds. Attacking third, middle third, and defending third. Throwing the ball in is Olivia Ball, I think. Hard to see in through this glass. No, that's Ball, who has the ball actually out of bounds for a goal kick. It was Myers with the throw-in. So, 1-1 here. anybody's game, obviously. Almost 30 minutes to go. We're about 30 and a half minutes still to play. Big district matchup here in 9AAA. Once again, this is Phil Newman with Alex Phillips.
We don't need a tie here.
Bringing you the broadcast. Alex saying we don't need a tie. We need to win this game. That would be hugely important for district regular season standings and also momentum going into the playoffs here fairly soon. So, can CPA get it going? There's Wampler dropping it back to Dye. Dye comes back inside. Curtis is far left. There's Dye. She shot the first goal, made the first goal. Andres back toward ball, toward Dye, rather. Myers challenging, played out to the left. Can Morris get there? She's so fast, but not quite, not that fast. Sarah Morris. Here Jomo will throw it in toward Howell. Can Andres get there? Boy, she's fast. She's able to at least send it off the end line, touch line there for a corner, or for the goal, a goal kick, rather. Andres is speedy for CPA. So is Wegner, who's not in the game right now. She's another speedy forward. And for Hume-Fogg, it's Morris, kind of their fastest player. Lochelt, center back, plays it up all the way up, but this gets Connolly, who gets there. Curtis is hustling to try to beat Orozco to it, and it's going to be off. They're going to say off of Lindsay Curtis. Curtis thought it was off of Hume-Fogg there, but they said nope. Orozco wins the throw-in. Michaela Howell plays back to Connolly. Connolly won by Morris. Morris is dangerous. Watch out. She's fast and fit here, but that time she plays it out of bounds. Good job by Myers there to shield her, shield Morris off of the ball, let it go out of bounds off of Morris. Hume-Fogg controls right there, though. Little lifting ball, dangerously played by Morris into the box, but Mary Morgan Smith is there to clear it away. 28 and a half minutes to go. So we're 42 in, about. Rather, 52 in, is that right? Yes. 52 in out of 80 minutes. Morris to throw in. Across the middle, dangerous, played up by Connolly, though. Connolly will get it up toward Andres. Andres heads it. There's Peebles fighting for it with Michaela Howell. Howell up toward Andres. A little back and forth kickball at the moment. Both teams hustling. That may be a foul, yes. Called against Andres. A little bit of hip. She came in on Laura Rethman and was called for the foul. So Peebles taking the free kick right here. Will she play it short or long? Hard to tell. She will go long. And there's Connolly with the header to Ball. Ball loses the first touch there. A little bit too far out in front of her. Peebles has it now. Peebles for Hume-Fogg. Myers. Connolly. Up in the direction of Andres. Can she get there? She will. Andres is a speedster. Maddie Andres. A couple different Madisons on the team, too. Madison Hamilton, also on the roster. Andres may have touched that one. She did, I think. It's off of CPA. Curtis gives a little clap toward Andres, saying, hey, good job, good work. We're getting some good things done. One of the things here in soccer, sometimes a coach will say, it's coming. Just keep doing what you're doing and be patient. And good results will follow. Here comes a sub. It's Wegner, I think. One of the orange shoe clad Lions tonight. The other is Cone, and that's not her. So Wegner will spell. Who went out? She's on the far side. Can't see from this distance. I think it's Andres, actually. Andres went out. She's sitting on the side. Here's a dangerous pick roll. Pickerel challenged it, but Mary Morgan played it nicely up. Curtis to Wampler. Wampler to Connolly. Connolly will look to go right wing to Wegner, who's just in the game. She should be fresh. But Morris plays it up. Morris keeps it in, left-footed. There, the goal she scored was left-footed, too. She must be a lefty, or at least really proficient left-footed. Pickerel with a nice spin move right there. Plays it inside, dangerous, through ball. And offside the call on Callie Brooks. It was Brooks, not Pickerel, making the spin move. Brooks passed the ball inside to, I think, Pickerel, who played a wall pass attempt back to Brooks, but it was offside. If you're not familiar with soccer, that means you're past the second-to-last defender at the time the pass is made toward you, and you play it, you're offside. You make a play on it. That was the first offside flag, I think, of the game. Alex says, yep. So we're usually see a lot more of that than we have tonight. Conley plays it back to Dye. They've got some mosquitoes in here, some bugs, there's some moths and wasps. Stay off the camera, guys. There's Dye. She'll play it way up. Nice, powerful leg. That was the same kind of leg that got that goal for her earlier. She's got a strong right foot. Here's Wegner. Kara, right?
Yep.
And she is dispossessed there. Here's Morris with it. Morris will play it up toward the front, but Lee is there to clean it out. To Wampler in the midfield. Now Conley has space and time. She can think about it for a moment, but she plays it under the leg of Morris. Still one back by Morris, though. Lee is there. It's Kara Wegner. Yep, the freshman, 15 in on the right side down here in the orange cleats. And it looks like we've got, is that McCullough? No, let's see. Playing forward up there in the yellow shoes. It's maybe it's Olivia Ball, actually. Yeah, they move Ball up to forward, looks like. Here's a shot. Dangerous. What a nice play by Roman to come out and get down and catch that one. Olivia Ball, right?
Yeah.
Yep, Ball's playing forward now. She was playing midfield earlier. She's been moved up, at least for the time being. Here's Howell. She'll try to get it up toward Wegner. Wegner plays it, but it's one. What's it called? It's a high kick, I think. Wegner playing against Abby Brown, number 7 there, and dangerous play. Indirect free kick right here, taken by Loschelt. Loschelt's ball up to Jomo. Howell slips down. Oh, nice header there by Pickerel. Dangerous for the moment. It'll be sliding in Roman to pick it up. She had a nice shielding help there for Mary Morgan Smith. Punt pass midfield off the knee of Peebles to Howell. Here's Curtis. Curtis will send it out to an overlapping Wampler. Wampler back inside. Nice pass to Ball. Ball will hold it up. Wait for some help. Now go up toward Wegner. CPA playing well on this possession right here. Wegner will cross it or try to. She does. Just off the foot, but there's Curtis. Curtis left-footed shot. It's in the net. What a play. Curtis blasted in off the arm or leg or something of a Hume-Fogg defender, and CPA goes back up 2-1. Great cross there from the freshman, Kara Wegner. It went right past the foot of somebody sliding in, maybe Wampler, and it came to Curtis, who blasted it left-footed off of a defender into the net. And the Lions, at 22 and a half minutes to go, second half, take the lead again at 2-1. Great play there, Alex. Man, my goodness.
Nice.
So momentum shifted back. CPA with a really nice build-up right there. They out of the back, down the right side. Wegner with a gorgeous
about
right-footed cross.
And a half to go.
Yep, we're about 58 almost in. My math is right, going backward there. I'm a journalist, not a math guy, you know. So here's Curtis, the goal scorer, with a left-footed blast in the middle toward Ball, who's playing up forward right now. They've got Ball up in the center. They've got Wegner on the right, playing like either attacking right mid or maybe another forward. It may be two forwards right now, 4-4-2. Lee plays it out. Whistle blows. What's the call? Lee saying, what'd I do? Referee called something against her, I think. I didn't see anything there. Looked like maybe a throw-in, but either way, he called it on Michaela.
We're getting a kick.
Yep, it's a foul. Maybe not against Michaela. Somebody against CPA. Here's a kick coming in from Peebles, 14. She'll take it. In swinger. Dangerous. Mary Morgan Smith with help from Conley, or rather Wampler. Peebles, though, will still control. Peebles will send it back in off the chest of Howell. Dangerous ball. Offside, though. Offside is the call. Roman made a great save anyway. They wouldn't have scored anyway. Roman slid in. It hit Howell going through the deal offside, though. The offside happens at the time of the pass. The pass is made, so it didn't matter that it hit Howell. It was just offside. So good call there, and Hume-Fogg fans don't like it, but I think it was the accurate call. nice play by Peebles to send it in, and great, even better play by Meredith Roman to slide in and make the save. Didn't need to make it, it turns out, but she was there. Boy, Roman is just tough. She's, matter of fact, she is the, what do you call it, the head girl for the Wallace House, mm-hmm. senior leader in more ways than one, basketball standout also, we know that. State champion in basketball.
She can shoot the three.
She can jack up the three, no question. Referee is blowing the whistle saying, hang on. He's talking to I think that's Kit Pickerel, rather, 17, yeah, it is. Catherine Pickerel, a sophomore, number 17, and she's playing forward right now. They've also got up there Brooks, and then Sarah Morris playing on the left, I think a left mid. So here comes Michaela with the offside kick off the leg of Peebles back to Loschelt. Here is Morris. Cut off by Lee, off her foot though. There's Mary Morgan to help out though. Wampler, nice touch up to Wegner. One back by Morris. Tackle coming. What's the call there? I didn't see much there. They called a foul against CPA's. Is that Hannah Ruff? No, that's Wegner, 15.
Yeah, that's Wegner.
Hannah Ruff graduated, I think. No, she's on the team, 14. I apologize. I think Hannah looks maybe a little, yeah, I don't know. Wagner reminds me a little bit of Ruff. But anyway, red hair, orange cleats. I'm confused.
Lots of M's.
Played in, that's right. Played in, off the leg of CPA. Left-footed shot. There's Roman with the save. What a shot taken. I think that was by Brooks, 27, if I saw that right. And good save by Roman. This game is really heated up, Alex. I mean, it's intense right now. Both sides.
I think we have the lead.
Absolutely. 2-1 Lions up, under 19 minutes remaining on the clock anyway. The referee will have the official time on the field. Here is Hume-Fogg, though. Jomo to Conley. Conley makes a funny, grabs her knees there to say, oh, not a great ball, not a great touch. She knew it. Peebles back inside. Peebles has been sending in dangerous balls last few minutes here for Hume-Fogg. There's Curtis, though. Curtis has the ball, plays it into Womp. She'll look for somebody not there. Good idea to come back the other side to die. Die mishits that one. Howell heads it, though. Nice job by Howell up to Wegner. Wegner, can she step through? Yes. Yeah, Wegner has the ball still. Wegner using her speed and skill. Look at Wegner go. Wegner down by to Loschelt, and she likes to take a shot, kind of a bad angle shot, trying to sneak the ball on the right left side of the goal there. Didn't quite work, but nice run there by Wegner. She got past Abby Brown on number 7, and was
CPA student section over there.
Some students down here. Oh, good to see that. Yeah, you can. Great to see some students. Maybe some football players after practice. I'm not sure, but I can barely see them. But that's great. They came out to support. Hard to do it from this angle.
Yeah,
we're getting the glass. We're at a tough angle, but CPA students have come out to support the girls. They came out Tuesday to support the volleyball girls as well.
It actually helps the houses.
Ah, they get points for coming to games. Okay, that's extra incentive. There's a win by Pickerel momentarily, but it's going to be Mary Morgan. Now played up by Hume-Fogg, but I think Roman's going to get there. Roman will play it. What will she do with it? She'll take her time, and then she'll clear it way up. To the midfield, there's Wampler. Wampler will control it. A little bit of a back heel. Back to Dye inside toward Andres, who's playing center mid right now. One of the center mids with Wampler. Up to Ball, who's playing forward. And over the outstretched leg of Wegner. Good idea there by CPA. Good movement. Just couldn't quite keep the ball down. Clock at 16:45 remaining. Second half, Lions 2-1. Can they hang on? Hume-Fogg is definitely not out of this game by any stretch. They've got some weapons. Beginning with Sarah Morris. Peebles also is tough. There's Crenshaw, number 6, up at forward now for in the game for Hume-Fogg. Here's Ball. Plays it out to Curtis. Curtis with left foot, cross it. Looking for Wegner. Crenshaw comes up and takes it, though, the keeper, Maddie Crenshaw. Rather, Lucy Crenshaw. Her sister is, I think, Maddie. I believe they're twins, if I'm right on that. I'm guessing they're twins, but I may be wrong. They look a lot alike, and they have the same last name, and they're the same year in school. Could be a good deduction.
I had the Mitchell twins. You wouldn't know they were twins.
That's true. Mm-hmm. Fraternal, in that case. Huh. All right. They'll be in action tomorrow night. Mm-hmm. Don on the line, Albert, quarterback. All right, here we go. Here's Dye on a run. Dye plays it up, but cut off nicely there by Hume-Fogg. Well done there by Hume-Fogg's Josie North. Now it's Morris, but she'll lose the ball out of bounds. So CPA had a Mickey Dye was on a run there, and North cut it off in the center mid area. Here's Howell. Up toward Wegner. Wegner fighting for it. On the ground is Peebles. Getting a little bit chippy here, if you will. There is Andres. Andres will look all the way left side. It gets to Curtis. Curtis guarded by Roscoe over there. Curtis will get past Roscoe. Left foot across, coming. And what a shot. What a goal. Wow. The Lions score. Curtis to Ball. And Ball slams it home. Great goal there by CPA. And a cramp. After the cross, Curtis went down with a cramp. Man, that was impressive. Curtis with a beautiful left-footed cross. And Olivia Ball, no doubt, into the back of the net with authority. I'm surprised the net's still there, actually.
We've now tripled Team Fogg's district goal total.
Absolutely. District goal total for both teams is 3-1 right now. Rather, yeah, 3 given up by Hume-Fogg. Alex Riley observes there. What an amazing play right there. Andres, I think, got the ball out to Curtis. Curtis went past Roscoe and crossed it, and there was the ball. Curtis still over there on the sideline. Matt Weitzel, the trainer with Star Physical Therapy, is working on her cramp, it looks like. I hope it's a cramp. Nothing more serious than that. I think it's a cramp. The way she went down and put that leg up, it looks like one of those calf cramps that are just excruciating. You almost want to die right there. Had plenty of those myself. It just hurts like the dickens. All right, so the Lions up 3-1. 14:45 rather, on the clock. So CPA is in the driver's seat now. Not over yet, though. You don't want to give up. In fact, there's Morris. Morris will go. Oh, what a move by Morris around Jomo. That was a sweet move. But there's Mary Morgan, who went it back in the middle. Mary Morgan up toward Wampler. Wampler will pause. Nope, play it over to Olivia Ball, who's back playing right, maybe on the right side. Here's Womp looking for who is in the middle. Howell's playing forward. She'll send it up all the way to Lucy. Lucy Crenshaw. I'll get it right eventually. That goal was impressive, Alex. I'll tell you what.
Very impressive.
Now we'll see if CPA's defense can keep shutting down the Blue Knights. Here for the Blue Knights, fighting for the ball in the middle there was Megan Pitts, 29, is in the game. Now it's won by her teammate Graves. Graves will cross it. It'll go out of bounds. Is it off CPA? No, it's a goal kick. Yes, I know, we're at a precarious perch here with this camera.
Yeah. Only this is gone.
Yeah, we got to get a huge glass wall here. It'd be nice. Alex Gamely running camera tonight, despite our limited space. There's a new partition up in the press box here tonight, though, put in by the great Ed Doris and Tay Ho. Put in this on the other side of the press box, a new wall and a door to help get some space for our broadcasters. We have My TV 30 coming in next Thursday night for the big game, TV game of the week. So check your local listings if you're in Nashville. We'll also try to broadcast it if we can find, get that going. We'll see. Just space-wise, really, it's a challenge to find the space with so many people who want to broadcast and want to do things here. It's a challenge. Here is Jomo up to Olivia. Ball looking for that's McCullough in the game now, 21, right? Mallory McCullough seeing her first action of the night. Played out of bounds by Hume-Fogg. That time it was Josie North. North playing it out. CPA throw in. So McCullough, 21. She is a senior. Thank you, Alex. McCullough had a good season last year and playing well this year. Here's a cross by Ball. Over the head. Is it in? The linesman says it's a goal. He does. It's in. Olivia Ball, her second goal of the game. That time it looked like it might have been a cross attempt, but it went over the head of Lucy Crenshaw, the keeper, and into the net barely. We'll update the score right here. Thank you, Alex. So Ball with her second goal of the game. The Lions fourth. Goal scored by Mickey Dye.
Two by Olivia Ball.
Two by Ball.
Curtis.
One by.
Right on Curtis.
I've forgotten.
No.
That's four. It's 4-1, right? Ball with two, yep. Die with the one long shot in the first goal. Who scored the other goal? Oh, boy. Might have been Curtis.
I think it was Curtis.
It was Curtis, I think, yeah. Because the ball came. It was a left-footed shot. It came past the center, and she was able to hammer it. And yeah, that's right. Off a defender and in. So 4-1, Lions comfortably ahead. Now, this game was closer than I think the score indicates. It's been a tight battle in a lot of ways. The CPA has just asserted themselves. Here is that Miller in the game, number 10 right there? Kendall Miller getting in the game. She with a lovely voice, among other gifts, sang at Coffeehouse Theater. Sang the national anthem last year, too. Of course, tonight we had Susanna Cranford and Casey Smith singing the national anthem. So a lot of multi-talented girls on the team. There's Curtis.
Both of them were also in Coffeehouse.
Oh, yes, sir. Right. Cranford and Smith sang a song together.
Hallelujah.
So they were up here in their soccer uniform singing the national anthem to begin the game. 11:21 on the clock remaining second half. Now it's academic, really. It's CPA will... Well, you never know. In soccer, anything can happen, but the momentum certainly on the Lions' side. Out will go Sarah Morris. Who's coming in? I lost track of who came in the game that time. Maybe it was... Might have been Crenshaw back in the game. Maddie Crenshaw. Throw in for CPA. No, actually, it's not. It's number 10, right? So that's going to be Ashley Perling back in the game, a sophomore. CPA throw in. 11 minutes to go, roughly thereabouts, second half. Big thanks to Alex. I know you're busy with homework and everything else, so thanks for helping us out tonight. Big, big, huge appreciation to Alex Phillips. Toughest class is what this year so far?
You have to go with statistics.
Statistics. Oh, stats, boy.
Stats is a tough one.
Whew. Teaching that. Who's the teacher of that?
Miss Melinda Herman.
Ah, Miss Herman. Yep. Okay. Here's a nice play up. Dangerous for the moment. They're taken by... Mary Morgan. That was a little bit of a risky one for Crenshaw. I would say for two of them, we said early in the game, we mentioned that the keeper's height could be a factor, and it has been. Really, two of those goals, contributing at least, was the height of Lucy. Not to denigrate her at all, but just some keepers are taller, some aren't as tall, and they have to rely on more athletic skills. In that case, CPA played the ball over her head twice. In the game comes Megan Roach, number 4. For CPA, out goes Wampler, I think. Also in for CPA is, let's see. Who else was new for CPA? Maybe just Roach. Megan Roach, junior, playing on the right mid. Here's Andres trying to win the ball. Played out there by Hume-Fogg. Good job by North. CPA throw. It'll be taken by Myers to Lee. Lee has a little bit of time here. Conley. Lee plays it all the way over to Dye. Dye has a wing midfielder. Plays it up to Andres. Andres in the center, though. Andres looking for Roach, and she won't quite get there. Left mid right now. Is that Miller over there? I can't see that far.
Yes.
Kendall Miller, number 10. Okay. Andres in the good shot by Curtis. She switched sides, at least for the time being here. So CPA is shifting their slots a little bit on the field to get Miller in on the left mid.
That would have helped her there.
Yes. Here's a good play by Mary Morgan. Here's Peebles up the middle. Peebles will send it through. It's going to be through all the way, but Roman will come way out and clear it up to Curtis. Peebles, though, wins it back. Plays it outside. There's Connolly. He's been strong in this midfield tonight. To Orozco. Over to North, out of bounds. 8.5 or so to go. So a game that was close. In this half, it was 1-1. CPA pulled away.
Still intense, though.
Still been intense. I said I think that's, if you watch the game, didn't know the score, it's definitely a little bit closer than I would think, 4-1, but CPA has converted on the opportunities they've had. I think Morris is back in the game now, 21 for Hume-Fogg, along with There she is. Matter of fact, Morris, along with number 29, Pitts, the freshman. Right there, Pitts will be 29. Here the ball comes in, though, toward Crenshaw. Maddie Crenshaw out of bounds off of her. Good call by the ref. That's right. Peoples thought it was their throw-in, but apparently didn't see it was off of Crenshaw's leg. About 7.5 to go. So CPA will remain undefeated in District 9 AAA. Hume-Fogg will fall to one loss in the district. And CPA will be in the driver's seat, if you will, moving toward the playoffs. There's Dye. Dye, that first goal was a thing of beauty. She blasted it. So powerful that it just hit over the hit Crenshaw's hands and went over into the net. Really couldn't do much about that. The keeper had tried gamely to stop it, but too much power on that one. Kick up toward Miller. Now it's McCullough, 21, back to Curtis. Curtis will send it way up toward, well, toward Roach, roughly, but it goes all the way to Crenshaw.
Roach was state track player.
Absolutely. Megan Roach, outstanding track athlete. Who else out here? Conley was a sprinting, I think, state champion in sprinting.
Yep.
4x4 or 4x1, I can't remember which.
Not sure.
But the girls definitely won. Last Coach Elson here. 4x4 or 4x1 for Conley and the girl, and at state champions in the 4x1 or 4x4. Conley was one of them.
4x4.
Clark, that's some others. Okay, 4x4. That's right. Conley was on it, I think.
Yeah,
just eight. Was it 4x8 maybe? Okay, that's right. Anyway, great track. So just point is, there's some cross sport, multi-talented athletes out here. 4x8, we're saying. Okay, good. Thank you, Coach. So Conley, one of those runners. I think Jessica Clark, maybe Caroline or Courtney Cohn was in that mix as well.
Yes, she was.
Courtney Cohn. Jessica Clark, Conley, and maybe Roach. I'm not sure. And Roach, that's right. Roach, yep. Roach, pole vault, excellent pole vaulter, along with for CPA on the boys' side, Chris Charles, right? Anyway, Hume-Fogg plays it up, headed by Mary Morgan. Played up in the general direction of Pitts, 29. She's challenging for it, but played out by Jomo. Now it's Sarah Morris. Morris tries to go inside the Pitts, but it was a little bit weak. Maybe she's just tired. She's been running so hard tonight, and man, really giving it all, her all.
Who's what? Is that Michaela Howell waiting to come in?
Howell. Yep, appears to be Howell on the far side, waiting to spell someone. There's Pitts. Plays it up toward Crenshaw. Taken away by Michaela Lee, though. Good job by Michaela. Strong center back. Stolen, though, back by Hume-Fogg's Rice. CPA will regain control here. About 4.5 minutes or so left on the clock. There's a melee there. Michaela falls over Peebles, I think. That's Curtis with the ball. She'll play it up. Orozco, though, wins it for Hume-Fogg. Back to Peebles. Peebles in the center mid area. Over to Morris. Sarah Morris, we'll see her again, I think, this season. She's with the ball right now, actually, just played it up. There's dangerous ball. There's Crenshaw. Roman. And played away by Dye. Two different Hume-Fogg players had a chance at that one. Counterattack by CPA. There's Roach fighting for it, but it's won back by the Blue Knights. Jomo. So that's a good save by, good job by Roman coming out, and then Dye to clear it away. Foul called there on Miller. She's not sure what she did. I think she may have inadvertently taken out.
Sweet girl.
Rice. She did that. She did that really nicely. Oh, I'm sorry. Were you in my way? is that how she's in the hallway too? Walk down the halls of school. I'll take you out if you're in my way. I'm late for class. Now, here's a nice ball, dangerous ball in. It's still alive. Peebles with a shot, and she does score. Well, here's a flag up, though. What's the referee? The linesman is calling something. I think he called offside. And there goes the head referee over to this AR, assistant referee, to figure out what to call. The flag went up kind of half-heartedly there for offside. Hold on, guys. Hang on. It may not be a goal yet. It might be offside. And it's going to be offside. No goal. Hume-Fogg doesn't like that one. I couldn't tell from here. I saw Peebles had two chances at it. The linesman, I didn't like. Here's the referee talking to Coach Tracy McLean over there. I really can't blame her for not liking that call, because the linesman honestly wasn't very definitive with that flag. It looked kind of like he was unsure. Flag went up, came down quickly. It was just one of those not very deliberate calls. They say if you're a referee, you're going to make a call, make it deliberately and mean it. That looked like more of a replacement ref type call. I guess right now we have the regular referees are back in the NFL.
Yes.
Beginning tonight. So
players very happy about that.
Absolutely. I really can't blame Coach McLean here for not being happy about this one. I got to be honest. I may have been offside, but Peebles did a good job there to get one foot on the ball. Then the rebound hit Roman made the save first, but off the rebound, Peebles put it back in the net. What's the deal? They're calling. It's a yellow card against somebody. Maybe the whole team. I don't know. Could be the coach. Could be a team yellow. That happens. No, it's never mind. It's no, not a yellow. It's just hand up in the air. I thought he had a yellow card in his hand. My bad. Forget that. Yellow. There was one card given early in the game to a Hume-Fogg player. No reds. No yellows for CPA. So about 2 minutes and change to go in this one. And the Lions will remain undefeated here in district play. And Curtis goes out. Okay, so good. Thank you, Alex. Howell with the ball right now, matter of fact, is in, the freshman. Coach Ellison mentioned at halftime, a lot of young players, several young players play key roles. Howell is one, Wegner is one. Who else are the freshmen?
You have to take out our defense.
There's CB winning the ball.
Wegner
is one. Olivia Ball, the other, and Joe Jomo Myers.
Two goals for Olivia Ball tonight.
Two goals for the freshman ball, absolutely. So that was youth is served tonight. Here's a header by Lee. Is Lee moving up a little bit? She may. Nope. Not. She's just playing a great ball there through by Wampler all the way to Miller. Can Miller get past Roscoe? No. Good job by Roscoe to recover and play out of bounds for Hume-Fogg. What a beautiful through pass there from Wampler to Miller. And only a good effort there by Madison Roscoe, the junior, saved a good chance for the Lions. Here they have the ball, though. It's McCullough, 21. McCullough is a, what do we say, senior? Yep, one of the seniors on the team for CPA. Not a hugely, not a large amount of seniors, if you will, but they play key spots. Here is cross in there by Wampler, headed by Miller back toward McCullough. McCullough will head the ball to control it. Good job there. CPA controls, but out of bounds off of Dye. Under 2 minutes to go in this one, so we're going to wrap it up here. CPA up 4-1, and they were in a tight one. Second half, they pulled away. It was Morris who tied the game one apiece at 46 minutes gone in the game, and then after that, CPA with three unanswered. Here's a steal by Peebles, though. Peebles, nice move by Peebles. She'll play it over to Brooks, 27 of the ball now. Brooks cuts it back inside, but off turns into the defender, and it goes off of Mickey Dye. One of the three Michaelas. Here is Conley up to Wampler. Nice move by the ref to move out of the way right there. McCullough has it. Senior. Looking for someone, doesn't find him. Finds a Hume-Fogg player at the moment. Ball played through. Roman comes way out again. She'll clear it away. Good job by Meredith. Up toward Howell. Maybe off her hand, but inadvertent no call there. There is Myers against Morris. That's a good test for Myers. That'll be a foul called against Sarah Morris. She didn't mean any harm there, but she got her legs tangled up with Jomo's. Here will be Michaela Lee. The free kick. Michaela looking forward to homecoming. Dance. There is Loschelt. Plays it out. Just messing with you there. Wonder what kind of corsage will be in the offing, perhaps.
Not sure if she has a dress yet, so you don't know.
May go in a soccer uniform for all we know.
Yeah.
Be different.
It was coming home, possibly.
Maybe so. A little dress down there for coming home in the spring. Or winter. When is that? That's in the spring, I think.
I think it's spring.
Peebles plays it up. Nice through pass for Peebles. There's Lee. Matter of fact, Roman will go with let the ball come into the box and then pick it up. As you know, that's the 18-yard box, the penalty box, if you will. No touching the ball outside the box. If you're the keeper, tangling up, that's going to be – well, hold on a minute. They call that against Hume-Fogg. Okay. Peebles call for the foul. Again, no harm meant there by either player. They just kind of got tangled up, it looked like to me. There goes the whistle. So that'll be the game. And CPA will win 4-1. Will be your final. In this big district matchup, the Lions are able to pull away. You see them, the handshake in the center of the field there. There's a lot of respect, I think, between these two programs. They're both strong teams, and they both have a chance to advance deeply into the playoffs this season. Let's go over the scoring one more time. So, first goal was Mickey Dye with a beautiful shot about 30 yards out from goal. Hit the keeper's hands, went over. Who's hurt out there? Someone's got a cramp, looks like, again. Hopefully it's only a cramp. It looks like, I'm not going to speculate. I can't see the number. But they're going to help her up. No, not sure. It looks like I hope it's a cramp. Anyway,
it looks like Michaela Howell.
Maybe Howell. So Dye with the first goal. Then second half, Sarah Morris for Hume-Fogg scores at the 46 minutes into the game mark to tie it up at one apiece on a left-footed shot that hit went off a defender for CPA and went in. It was just an unfortunate bounce and a good shot by Morris. After that, three goals for CPA, one by Lindsay Curtis, left-footed blast, and two by Olivia Ball, the freshman. So that was the scoring summary for you, 4-1. And Matt Weitzel there, you see, working on, it is Howell, we think?
I think so.
Perhaps the cramp. So good game for CPA to hang in there and persevere.
Yep.
Alex, you saw it. Any observations or thoughts about how the Lions perform tonight?
Lots of goals. Lots and lots of goals.
Good to see them put it in the net.
Lots of young players getting Olivia Ball, two goals.
Absolutely.
Miss Wenger, the other freshman, with an assist.
Wegner, yep. So they're the
Curtis.
You see CPA gathering in the middle there for a little bit of they do their post-game talk and prayer. Hume-Fogg doing the same thing, having a talk on the other end of the field. So we're going to sign off by saying once again thanks. Thanks to Alex Phillips. Big thank you. Thanks to Coach Mike Ellison for the halftime interview. And great job for CPA's victory tonight. Remain undefeated. Stay with us. Tomorrow night we're going to bring you the football game live here on the same network. So join us tomorrow night if you can't be in the den. And we'll hopefully bring you some more soccer action later in the season as well. So this is for Alex Phillips. It's Phil Newman here. There's Michaela Howell getting up and walking it off. She'll maybe get some ice. And so from CPA, good night. Have a great night. And we'll see you soon here back at the Academy.